here are doing these two. Rossi, absolutely magnificent at the end of this strike. We ride with Casey Stoner, Rossi right behind him. You watch, it's going to come out of the slipstream any moment now. Stoner won't let him. Here comes Rossi, let's start to pray. Now! Well done, Casey Stoner. Oh! Stoner's gone past the Vizioso. Brilliant stuff by Casey Stoner.
So you're watching out for Valentino Rossi's there, and it's actually Stoner who ran it very deep on the brakes and frozen. To Valentino Rossi just a few metres more, and that took him past Andrea Vizioso. Antonio Lias has received a black flag.
Yeah, what a weekend from an Ingram Rossi. Got past Andrea Vizioso. Valentino Rossi now up in the third place. 16 and a half laps to go. We should have a go at Stoner straight away. Up the inside of Stoner. He's gone through. Rossi means business. Rossi now in the second place. Surely he can't do anything
about Danny Pedrosa at the front. I don't think so. Danny Pedrosa is 6.2 seconds ahead. Stoner at 1.44 on that last lap, and that's all down to that, so where he ran off the gate. Watch out where he ran wide at turn 4. This time, Rossi made his way through there. He obviously saw that was a vulnerable point for Casey Stoner, makes his way through. It was like that last year as well, wasn't it? And Stoner tried to come straight back, not this time, to slide the rear, going into a Deutsche corner. But it's not going to be this time for Casey Stoner. And he's got to make the attacks too. Try and hang on to Valentino Rossi here.
Up past the grandstands. Tony Elias. Oh dear. What did you say? Local lad. Jump start. He's ignored it. He's not seen it. Black flag down in the show.
He's seen it now. He's dropped right up. He looked like he's set up there. And he's really looking riding hard. Down the home straight, Valentino Rossi in second spot. Danny Pedrosa is leading us through by 6.5 seconds. Casey Stoner in second place, third position just behind him. Andrea Vizioso in fourth, then in fifth. Colin Edwards just behind them and still in touch with Randy Lepunier. Nicky Hayden a further 1.6 seconds back then for Newland in eighth. Captain Rossi is in ninth, then James Tozer in tenth position.
And that goes turning the car three into a pit box. And then he's going through the pits. I don't think he knows it was black flag, because he did. The black flag was actually out in this lap, not the lap before. And then he's been stopped at the end of pit lane though. Yeah, but his team just said penalty for his last time out, so he thought that that was the time to come in for the penalty to stop him. So he missed the black flag.
So this will be for my capital of Canadians. Good races for second place, Valentino Rossi, still running on Kevin Stoner. Back up at Randy Dupree, all around now by Colin Edwards. We've almost forgotten about Danny Pedrosa. What a ride by Pedrosa. He gets away at the front, he's almost impossible to beat. I think the race for second will, well, perhaps not for second, because Rossi may break this up a little bit. Behind him is going to be tight and fast.
Valentino Rossi riding with a football and a helmet this week. It's the European Championship in Italy, a playing tomorrow night. He wanted to give the boys a bit of a boost by showing them support. He's got a full kit, got a shirt on and his leather, and then he's got the short painted on there. He's got the football boots painted on his feet as well. All the pictures are actually supposed to be his feet.
They're
really luring the pictures here. Let's give that hat to the problem.
The world's most prestigious sports car endurance race.
Then I was almost something special.
This is crazy.
24 hours of Le Mans.
Anything can happen.
Live Saturday, 8:30 a.m. Eastern, only on.
So Stoner's not out of him yet, he's keeping the pace going, and Pedrosa's just dropping off slightly, and he looks like he's lost Randy Lepunier. There he is, Randy Lepunier, he's fuming, he's trapped out of the race once again. Well, we just said he just needed to put it like home, sixth place wouldn't have been too far, but you can see he's absolutely disgusted with himself or with something.
Amazing, the sort of half stage that not even halfway through the race, only to settle down a bit. Suddenly, we lose Alex Angelis, Loris Caprossi, and Randy Lepunier.